Chris Dastoff from SA Footballer Magazine with this week's club legend, Pembroke's Tom Evans. How are you, Tom?
Good, thanks, Chris. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. So when did you first get involved in the club?
I came out in 2008, finished school at Pembroke School, and it was just the obvious choice to go out and play for the old schoolers team. And I still remember my first game to this day, playing with John Cunningham and a few Pembroke club legends, and it was a good experience, and I remember I was hooked from the first game. So yeah, 2008 was my first experience with the club. Yeah.
And what have been your big accomplishments at the club?
Obviously, it's hard to go past winning a premiership. 2016, we got the job done in Division 3. That was a really good day and a special day for the club. We hadn't won one since, I think it was 97 or 98. So it was some great celebrations afterwards. And it was a result of a few years of hard work and toil, just avoiding relegation a few times, and to come out the other end and to win a premiership with some great mates that you've got for life is an amazing accomplishment.
And what does it mean playing for the club that you went to school at as well?
It's great. I love playing for the Kings. We get to play with a lot of kids that come through the school, and I'm lucky enough to teach at the school as well, so get to play with kids who I've coached going through, and can create a really, really good culture in that sense. And we got a great oval in Haslam Oval, and good support staff, and good sponsors as well, so it's a really good culture, and just love being able to represent the green and gold for Pembroke.
And how long have you been teaching at Pembroke as well?
I've been there about 7 years now, so I teach a bit of health and PE, so quite enjoy that. And coaching the junior footy at the school as well gives me a good link in between the old scholars and the school footy, and hopefully trying to create a little bit of a pathway for kids to come out once they finish their schooling.
And when did you become a football director?
I've been on the committee for a couple of years now. We've got a lot of us that do a lot of hard work, and so I think sort of this year I've started taking on more of that football director role, which is good. And we're a very, very much a player driven club, so a lot of the people on the board are current players, and we do a lot of work week in, week out in trying to make sure everything's right to go for match day. So I enjoy being on the committee, and we have some good social events during the year, and organising things like quiz nights and raffle nights and things like that. So yeah, I've enjoyed being in. The more you put in, the more you get out of the club, and it's just a good place to be in a good environment. So, yeah.
All right, thanks, Tom. This is Chris. One more as well. Club sponsors for this year.
Club sponsors. Okay, there's a few. Hopefully, I don't miss out on any. I might even just read it out just to be sure. I know we've got LJ Hooker on board, who are great in the housing game there. There's a couple others here. We've got Berry Funerals, who've been on board for a long time. Simon Berry and the Berry family, great sponsors over the years. The Robin Hood Hotel is our club rooms, so we go back to the Robin Hood, which is a fine establishment. Great meals, great drinks as well, so Robin Hood Hotel, definitely worth getting in for a look. Got Crowey's Paints, who are pretty heavily advertised as well. So got Ryder Levitt Bucknell, who are a quantity surveying organisation, so our captain, Charles Canny, actually works with those guys, and they're our Guernsey sponsors, so he's big in the quantity surveying game, so just a bit of a shout out to Charles Canny as well.
All right, thanks, Tom. This is Chris Dassel from SA Footballer Magazine. I'll see you next week.